Tell me, a dad's watching us right now, and he hasn't been as faithful to church and the things of God as he should be, or a mom. Give them something that they can push off against towards their new legacy.
Yeah, I think that, you know, a lot of people want these hard times to get over with and get back to normal. But what if we don't get back to normal? There's never a perfect time to, you know, do what's right. And I would encourage everyone, you start right now where you're at. I think I'm a pastor, so I love when it's a packed house. And I don't think we're going to see a packed house for a little while. But that does not change that God can't move. Because God can move. Dad, here's the thing. Your sanctuary is not where you gather on Sunday morning. Your sanctuary was always supposed to be your living room. Was supposed to be your house.
Yes.
And so I would just say, you know, pray with your kids, listen to your kids, because that's what they're going to remember. They're not going to remember how many Netflix shows they watched 10 years from now. They're going to remember dad bowing down on their bedside and praying with them every night and talking to them about Jesus. And so just start right where you're at, and you don't have to be the professional preacher. No, and you don't have to be the professional pastor. The professional pastor is overrated. You're supposed to be the priest of your home. Yes. And
no one loves the legacy. No one loves your kids like you do.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And I think the reason my kids are love God and love the ministry, you know, a lot of pastors' kids don't love the ministry and rebel against it. And I think the reason our kids love the ministry and love God and love his church is simply because we did exactly that. Every night was God time and kid time. And they saw authenticity. They didn't see us one way at church and another way at home.